إن الحمد لله
نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we ask His help and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil inside us and from the evil consequences of our bad actions. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no God to be worshipped but Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our master, our teacher, our leader. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah. Brothers and sisters, Sayyida Aisha, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once asked him, Ya Rasulullah, O Prophet of Allah, هَلْ جَاءَ عَلَيْكَ يَوْمٌ هُوَ أَشَدُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ يَوْمِ أُحُدٍ. She asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, have you encountered a day harder than the day of Uhud? Is there a day worse than the day of Uhud? And the day of Uhud is the battle of Uhud, a battle that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost. He lost that battle. He lost 70 of his companions. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was injured in the battlefield. And so you will think that this is probably the worst day of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the answer was no. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَقَدْ لَقِيتُ مِنْ قَوْمِكِ مَا لَقِيتُ. I've seen so many troubles, you know, or your people cause so many problems to me. But the worst day of my life is when I عَرَضْتُ نَفْسِي عَلَى ابْنِ عَبْدِي وَلَيْلِ فَلَمْ يُجِيبُونِ إِلَى مَا أَرَدْتُ. The worst day of my life is when I went to At-Ta'if, to Banu Thaqif, to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they did not respond the way I expected. They did not respond the way I expected. That's exactly what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلَمْ يُجِيبُونِ إِلَى مَا أَرَدْتُ. We all know the story. We know what happened to him. We know what these people did to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, having their kids and their foolish running after him, throwing rocks at him, he was bleeding. And we knew all this detail from Zayd ibn Haritha, the one who accompanied the Prophet. But the Prophet's response was, they did not respond the way I expected. Period. And that's it. Why didn't Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us about details? Why didn't he talk about the trials and the frustrations and the bad breaks that he had in his life? Yeah, why didn't he do that? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not have that what we call, you know, victim mentality. When you talk about misfortune, when you talk about trials, when you talk about what people, the wrong things that people did to you, the things that you didn't get in life, yeah, you opening the door to bitterness. And bitterness can ruin your attitude, can ruin your entire life. Every single one of us, brothers and sisters, will go through trials. That's a part of who we are. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the Quran. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, surely you will be tested. In so many different locations in the Quran. So it's a part of being human on this earth. You will be tested. Not even human, even animals, they go through trials. Right? But the one thing that hurt us the most though is when people do us wrong. And here's a fact. Having people saying things about you or causing you troubles, it's not going to stop. It's not going to go anywhere. It's not. This is also another, it's a part of who we are as humans. Having people saying evil things about you, having people causing you troubles, is not going to go anywhere. No matter who you are, no matter the relationship that you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you do not have the power to keep that from stopping, or to stop that from happening. It's going to happen. But you have the choice. You have the choice to how to respond to things like that in your life. If you hold on to the grudge, if you hold on to the hurt, thinking, why did they say that about me? Why did my ex-wife say that about me? Why did my ex-husband say that about me? Yeah, why my business partner did this to me? Why the people in the community or in the neighborhood at work, why did they say these things about me? When you keep doing that, definitely you're opening the door to bitterness. And when you are bitter, it affects everything in your life. It affects every area in your life. It poisons your attitude. It makes you see things in a negative way. Bitter people don't really have good relationships. They are easily offended. And when you are bitter, the only person that you hurt here is yourself. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam really, he didn't talk much about that. Right? لَمْ يُجُوبُونِي إِلَى مَا أَرَدْ. Yeah, they didn't respond the way I expected. They say bitterness is drinking poison and waiting for the other person to die. No, being bitter, it only harms you. It only hurts you. And you might have a legitimate reason to be bitter. But holding on to it, it's only going to make it worse. It's going to steal your dream. It's going to rob you from your joy. So let go. Really, just let go. How do I do that? Forgive. Forgive quickly. Forgive. Forgive those who hurt you. Forgive those who wronged you. And I'm not asking you to be an ideal, because probably forgiving people who hurt you, cost you so many troubles, you and your family, probably it is the hardest thing in this life. And some people ask sometimes, to what extent can I? Well, it depends on you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, forgive and let go. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِرْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. He said, fight evil with good. If people, you know, disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how they treat you, you know, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how you treat them. But sometimes you find yourself in a toxic situation. You know, there are people who are intoxicating your entire life, ruining all your relationships. Not only your relationship with your family and friends and the people around you, but even your relationship with Allah. If it comes to that level, then really, you don't need an advice from anybody. Then you stop. Then forgiving is not really happening. Forgiving that person is not really doing you anything good. Don't be naive. You know, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, probably the master of the first generation of the people who came after the Sahaba, what we call them Tabi'een. This man said something so powerful, right? He said one day, Wallahi inni la uhallilu ma harram Allah. By Allah, I do not allow anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited. فَلَقَدْ حَرَّبَ اللَّهُ عِرْضِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it prohibited for others to, you know, accuse me falsely or to slander me or to try to destroy my image, my name, my reputation. That's haram. كُلُّ الْمُسْلِمِ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ حَرَامِ دَمُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَعِرْضُهُ. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, right, that you cannot talk about people's image, you cannot talk about the reputation of people, you cannot accuse them falsely, you cannot take their money. So he said, I will not allow anything that Allah prohibited. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited for people to accuse each other falsely. فَمَنْ تَكَلَّمَ فِي عِرْضِي, that whoever said anything wrong about me, لَا أُسَامِحُ, I will never forgive him. This is so powerful, especially it came from somebody who was so righteous and a great scholar as well. وَأُحَاسِبُهُ أَمَامَ اللَّهِ, and I will take my right from him before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hesitated a little bit, should I share this with you or not? Because that also can open the door for some of us sitting in this room, oh yeah, I'm like Saeed. Those people, you know, they hurt me so many times, I cannot forgive. You know, forgive. Forgive. And I'm not saying that you forget your pain. Yeah, don't forget your pain. Your pain actually could be a way to motivate you to do other things in life. But don't become bitter. Don't become sour. Ahmad ibn Hanbal, the great Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, may Allah have mercy on his soul. During his life, he went through a huge trial that's called Khalq al-Quran. That people, he was actually accused and he was put into prison, he was tortured, he was flogged. And he was abused, he was insulted, they tortured him until he almost died. And by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he came out of it. And he forgave every single person who insulted him or was the cause of him spending these years in prison. To the point he forgave people who died before they sought his forgiveness. And one of the things that he said, rahimahullah, he said, لَقَدْ جَعَلْتُمْ مَيِّتَ فِي حِلٍّ مِنْ دَرْبِهِ إِيَّاهِ, that I have forgiven every person, every deceased person for hitting me. And his son once asked him, Father, how can you forgive somebody like that? And even they said, even the guards of his prison cell, they came and they sought his forgiveness and he forgave them. Even the person who was holding the whip, he forgave him. So how can you do something like this? He said, Ya Bunay, my son, I read in the Quran, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ, that whoever forgives and pardons, then his reward is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will tell you something. When you read something like that in the Quran, that Allah is not really giving you the reward, he's not exactly telling you what the reward is, he's saying the reward is with Allah, that's because your human intellect cannot comprehend the immense reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is having for you. You cannot even think about the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is having for you, and so he's saying your reward is with Allah. And then Ahmad ibn Hanbal also said, and I heard a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِذَا وَقَفَ الْعِبَادُ لِلْحِسَابِ يُنَادِي مُنَادٍ لِيَقُمْ مَنْ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. He said, on the day of judgment, a caller will come and say, don't stand up unless Allah owes you some reward. SubhanAllah. Don't stand up, don't come forward unless Allah owes you some reward. SubhanAllah. And then he said, no one will stand up except those who forgive others in life. And I want to be among those people. I don't care about what happened in life. You know, I forgave people not because they are worthy of my forgiveness. I just forgave them because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked me to forgive and move on. You know, every single time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing the oppressor and the oppressed in the Quran, almost every 99% of time, Allah, when he addresses the oppressor and the oppressed in the Quran, first, or he talks about the oppressor, he first addresses the oppressed, the wrong. And in some passages, he only addresses the oppressed. And you know what he says to him? Forgive. And guess what? Don't just forgive, you know. Forgive and move on. Don't hold this grudge. Don't hold that hurt. Why? Because that can ruin you as a human. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the oppressed first. Because He doesn't want you to get ruined. He doesn't want your heart to be ruined. He wants you to forgive and move on. And the other thing that you should do also is let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be your defender. Let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be your protector, your vindicator. Say, Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. And not just say it, live it, feel it, believe in it, act upon it. That Allah is my defender, that Allah is my protector, that Allah is my vindicator, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of all of my affairs. Don't go around carrying loads of, you know, grudges and resentment and bitterness, anger and revenge. It will weigh you down. Wallahi, it will weigh you down. Wallahi, they will destroy your life. See what happened to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When was Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bitter? When did he hear the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam complaining about what these people did to him? He was kind. He was gentle. He used to smile to people. Never returned rudeness with rudeness, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why he was healthy. His heart was sound. His heart was full of love, mercy, and forgiveness for people. So don't go around carrying all these loads of bitterness. You know, wallahi, if we start to take revenge for every single, you know, act of injustice, we will not stop taking revenge. I'll say it again. If we start going around taking revenge for every little unjust act that happened to us, we will not stop taking revenge. This is not what life is all about. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to forgive and let go. Let go for yourself, for your hearts, to maintain that soundness of your hearts. You know, save that energy. You know, bitterness is always knocking on the door. And life is so short to live offended and bitter. You know, don't waste your energy on these things. Your energy is valuable. You know, so spend it on your life, at home with your children. Yeah, and wallahi, when you let go with bitterness, you will have your joy back, inshaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse our hearts from bitterness, from resentment, from anger, from revenge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse our hearts from any flaw or any error of the heart. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Astaghfirullah al-azim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما انفعنا اللهم زدنا علما اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep our hearts straight on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the righteous servants, the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from any type of grief and anxiety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from poverty, laziness, and inability. Allahumma ameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also to protect the people who were injured or those who died even with all this fire in Australia. I was reading something today in the news, and I've seen a huge number, even animals, like millions of animals died, subhanAllah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect human souls, Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all communities, Allahumma ameen. Allahumma aj'al hadha al-jam' jam'an marhuma, wa tafarruqna min ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'asuma, wa la taj'al fina wa la baynana shaqiyan wa la mahruma. Allahumma man wali min amri al-muslimina amran farafaq bihim farfuq bih. اللهم من ولي من أمر المسلمين أمرا فرفق بهم فارفق به، ومن اشتد عليهم فاشدد عليه. آمين آمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم، واسألوه يعطكم، واستغفروه يغفر لكم. أقم الصلاة.